on there, everyone. Well, as everyone knows, our nation was rocked by two horrific mass shootings this weekend. So far from, I didn't make a video this weekend on it because I was waiting for as much information to come through as possible and doing my own research, you know, scouring the web to see what I could find out about these two individuals. And it's pretty much confirmed now that they're both from different sides of the ideological pie. You had one far-right white nationalist extremist terrorist, and then you had what seems to be pretty conclusive that the other guy from Ohio was a far-left type of extremist. We got to end this stuff, man. Americans killing Americans, there's no need for it at all. There's just no need for it. I don't understand exactly, which is a good thing, the mentality of these people. You know, I'm glad I don't understand their mentality, because that would be terrifying. And I would probably check myself into an insane asylum or something if I did fully understand them. I've read through the El Paso shooter's manifesto, and he's typical white nationalist type rhetoric. You know, racist. It really does hurt my heart. It's been a rough weekend. I hate seeing this type of thing happen. Y'all know I'm all for gun rights and this, that, and the other. And every time something like this happens, it's not the coward shooters that have to suffer any of the consequences. It's all of us that are left out here in the real world that have to suffer the consequences of their actions. But when it comes to what's causing this, I think for most people, you can kind of get it. What's causing this? And maybe it's just my opinion, but I firmly believe that the legacy media has a big role to play in it. You know, every time you turn on something like CNN or MSNBC, they're talking about how evil men are, white males in particular. Yes, we do have a problem with the radicalization of young white males between the ages of, 19 and 23. This is a problem. They're disenchanted. Society has cast them as a problem. You know, and instead of trying to help these people with open arms and try to talk to them and try to get them to have some sense about reality, the media and stuff demonizes. You know, Don Lemon, one of his favorite quotes was, you know, we have to address the problem of white males in this country. You know, stuff like that can mess with a young person's mind. They're constantly hearing about how they're seen as bad and evil, which can make someone bad and evil. And the president, about roughly an hour ago, had a speech on TV addressing these situations, and he made a lot of sense. I think they're barking down the wrong tree when they say it's a video game problem. That's like a classic late 1990s, early 2000s Republican chant when violent situations like this happen. I think video games are more of a scapegoat. I've played violent video games my whole life, and never have I wanted to go do something stupid because of it. Not at all. In a way, I see video games as exactly the opposite. They can, when someone's thinking crazy, they can go play a video game, and maybe that'll calm their head. But that's more of a parental issue anyways. That would be a parental issue, you know? If you're the parent of a kid, you should know your kid well enough. You should know his mental status well enough to know if he or she should not be playing these violent video games. Maybe they just can't handle it. But that also goes on, falls on the parents a little bit. And then, another thing is, President Trump mentioned the internet. Now the internet is radicalizing young men. Well, that I believe that could be true to an extent. What else is, I think, furthering this radicalization is the fact that so many people are being banned for their opinions and their views on things. And then when you ban them, and this is something us online commentators have been talking about for quite some time now, when you ban someone from the big public forums, you make them go to the deeper, darker areas where they end up surrounding themselves with either like-minded people or people that'll try to egg them on to do something stupid, whether they believe the person, same ideological views as the person or not. You know, we live in what's called a shit-posting world. People who will post anything just to get a reaction. And sometimes those reactions can be what we've seen this weekend. You know, I've said it numerous times. I don't know how many videos I've said it. Pretty much every time one of these events happens, I say it. If you see something, say something. It's not snitching or narking on someone when you can save their life and others. You know, people got to stop trying to, I don't know why people do that. You know, people just won't say anything for some fear of something. But we have to start policing ourselves, people. We live in the greatest country in the world. Let's keep it that way. Let's keep it that way. There's no sense in all this violence. There's no sense in the media constantly just picking on one group of people. You know, it's not just one group of people. One, to me, the far right are just more capable of pulling off these type of things. But it's not just them, you know. And I'm not particularly trying to make this an argument against far-right extremism versus far-left extremism. I think it's all bad. I mean, I condemn all of it. I condemn anything that's going to get an American citizen harmed, you know. I don't care whether you're on the right or the left. You're my fellow American, and by God, I love you for it. But we really need people see these warning signs. People on the internet see these warning signs. Take a screenshot. Send it to the authorities, you know. Just the person's generally not going to get in actual trouble. Because, I mean, they can't. They haven't done anything illegal. But they can be talked to. And maybe the situation can be de-escalated before it even starts. Is that the right thing to do? It's not going to hurt. I don't think it can hurt. These people need help. They need mental health help. And I don't think they're getting it. Because most people that need the mental health help aren't going to seek it on their own. You know, it's just a sad reality of it. I don't know what's going to keep happening. If the media rhetoric stays the way it's been, when you have politicians, big name media pundits, and all this stuff constantly coming out against white males, I feel that whether it's from the right or the left, you're going to see more things like this happening. But it's going to be for different ideological reasons. But it all is going to stem from the same trigger factor, you know, same flashpoint. We got to deal with this. We got to deal with this as a nation, and we can do this without enacting a bunch of crazy, intense laws which will affect everybody fairly negatively, or without propagating the rise of authoritarianism to where we give the government too much power over us. That's a big fear of mine, is when these events happen, the government is always very quick to try to enact some type of legislation. But we have to remember as a people that every time that happens, it's generally stripping us of something. So we're walking a very fine line between freedoms and authoritarianism through these mass shooting incidents. And we really, as a nation, got to get our handle on it. We got to get a handle on this. And we can do it. Americans can do anything we put our minds to. If we set a goal, we can make it happen. But we got to work together. We have to cross party lines or ideological lines, and we have to come together and get this straight. No one should be condoning violence. No one. It's crazy. You go on Twitter, and I know I'm being rather biased right now because I'm on the right, but you go on Twitter, and you'll see all these left-wing verified blue checkmark people constantly talking up violence, you know? If someone does something here, they're like, oh, you should... It's just ridiculous, you know? Some people are practically promoting violence and terrorism, but yet they're still around to do so. They don't get sent to they don't get banned, and they don't get put on a tiny platform or somewhere deep in the internet. Mm-mm. They're allowed to sit there and spew their hate right there in the open. Well, why shouldn't we allow that for other groups? Because at least we can keep an eye on these people better. You know, at least people can call them out because they're there. They're in the public sphere. But we're relegating some of the most extreme, like I said earlier, to go deeper into the web to where they're not as easy to monitor. They're not as easy to spot out. Or they go and find somewhere where they're not going to be called out for anything, because there's going to be like-minded individuals who try to amp more crazy individuals up that might actually do something. And I believe that's what we're seeing a lot now. It's going to be up to us, people. We can't just depend on the government to do everything, because all they're going to do is take our rights and take everything away from us that they can. We got to start doing something for ourselves. Like I said, if you see something, say something. Speak up. Don't see yourself. Don't feel weird about it. Don't feel like you're just being a rat or something. You're not. You're possibly saving countless lives by saying something. But that's all I'm really gonna say about this. Like I said, it's a very rough subject. I hate it. I don't like seeing Americans kill Americans. I don't like seeing people die, period, you know? Every life to me is valuable. There's no reason for it. There's no reason for it at all. But hopefully the next videos, I'll be able to perk the mood up and lighten up a little bit. Just final words, my thoughts and prayers are with the families, victims, anybody that was affected by these senseless tragedies. And we are America. We'll get through this. I stand with all those affected. And let's hope things get better before they get worse. Let's hope we can avoid what seems like a dang civil war getting ready to pop off. Let's hope we can avoid that, because that ain't going to do nothing for nobody. As always, like, share, and subscribe. I will catch you on the flip side.